I'm the speaker for the training program today. My name is Sharon. So today I'm going to briefly talk about the topic I'm going to share with you. It's the culture and values. Okay, so what is training? Training is to help a person to increase their knowledge and then help them to perform tasks more effectively and efficiently. So the working performance will be improved. Not only that, training is in contrast to education because it is more specific on a particular topic, but education is more towards in general sessions. Okay, is training important? Is it important?
Yes.
Yeah, so the importance of training, so it is to address the weakness of the learners, so they will be able to improve on the mistakes they make and on which part they need to improve. So automatically the performance will be improved as well when they know what weakness they have and what to improvise. So the quality of products and service will be improved as well. The consistency of work quality of the employees. And then this will also build employee satisfaction, and which will lead to lower employee turnover rate. And training will also help an employee to improve their adaptability to the increased diversity at the workplace. It will also reduce wastage as well in terms of cost and time. So what is learning? Learning is the activity or process of gaining knowledge or skill by studying, practicing, being taught or experiencing something, the activity of someone who learns. So I will talk about the overview of my training program. Three topics I have is on culture values, learning organization, organizational learning, and change and organizational development strategies. Okay, what is culture? Culture is the amalgamation of values, vision, mission, and the day-to-day aspects of communication, interaction, and operational goals that create the organizational atmosphere that pervades the way people work. So the next will be the learning organization and organizational learning. It is a set of organizational actions such as the knowledge acquisition, information distribution, information interpretation, memory that consciously or unconsciously affect on positive development of an organization. What is organizational learning? So it is a change in the organization that occurs as the organization acquires knowledge, information distribution, information interpretation, and memory that consciously or unconsciously affect the positive development of an organization. So this is a process of organizational learning. First will be the knowledge acquisition first, and then you share the knowledge with the employees. And then they will learn how to interpret the knowledge, and then they will gain knowledge, and then they will utilize it to the maximum. So what does change mean to you? Change is a set of tools, processes, skills, and principles for managing the people side of change to achieve the required outcomes of a change project or initiative. It is through several activities that allows you to make a change to improve for the better and to improve your work performance. And it is also the change management professionals can be more effective and credible within the organizations and projects to support the learners. Okay, what is change management? Change management involves a few steps. It is to change, to plan, to initiate, to relax, to control, to stabilize. And it is to determine the set of tools and then processes you use to change. Okay, these are the components of the change management. It involves strategy, organize, measure, improve, teamwork, and motivate. Why do you want to change? Okay, involves your action, changes, and things. Okay, according to Mahatma Gandhi, you need to be the change you wish to see in the world. Okay, so I'm going to cover on the topic that I'm going to share today. It will be culture and values. So the brief outline, I will talk about the definition, characteristics, types, and importance of culture and values, how culture affects, encourages employee learning, consequences of the influence of culture and values on your organization, and how you can start developing a good culture for better work movements. So these are the components of culture. So it is art, drama, music, attitudes, beliefs, language, customs, rituals, behavior, faith, religion, and food. Okay, why do I use culture? So the importance of culture, increase efficiency and effectiveness of a learner, work productivity and the profit. It also increase employee satisfaction, improve mindset among employees, a develop sense of ownership and accountability, improve adaptability to change according to the environment you're always going into. And then a culture of knowledge, inquiry, and sharing. So according to Jim Grace, organizational development can promote holistic values. So I've done a case study on Starbucks. So everyone knows Starbucks, right? Yeah. So Starbucks, it provides a few of training programs. Okay, there will be barista basics training program, the shift supervisor training program, retail management training program, which is known as the assistant store manager, and also the district manager training program. So you can see there are many training programs that Starbucks have provided, which is why they have a good brand image and performance, okay. So next will be the Starbucks training program. So there are a few key strategies they implemented for the program they intend to provide for the learners. So firstly is the well-roundedness. Starbucks puts new employees through a strict training regime in their first 2 to 4 weeks of the job. The new recruits should complete at least 24 hours of training. Okay, the next will be the precise standards, coffee making techniques, recipe memorization, ordering procedures, sanitary and practices. Because Starbucks, they don't only rely on the quality of their coffees and the quality of their products and services. They also need to make sure that their employee knows how to serve their products the right way. So the third one will be the hands-on learning. Starbucks incorporates large doses of hands-on experiences into its training programs. So Starbucks want to make sure that their employees get their hands dirty on the first day of their job and make sure that they know how to work on every single procedures the first day. So this is the sales growth of the Starbucks. As you can see, it has been growing until 2015, gradually. So these are the characteristics of the culture. It will be the vision, values, practices, people, narrative, and place. So every company has a vision and vision, isn't it? So mission will be the steps and how the company thinks that they want to end up at. So the vision will be how they want to implement the strategies to reach where they want to go. So there will be the people who are involved in this culture. Culture is the way you think, act, and interact. And according to Anastasia, culture is something that unites people. Okay, so next one will be, what is value? Okay, there's a broad importance of the values. So value broadens the knowledge of various types of values, and then encourage positive values and discourage negative influences. Values also opens up one's minds, builds unity due to increased diversity in organization, because organizations, they will have like difference in the diversification, and then like they will have different races and people. So you have to learn how to run on the unity and teamwork value. So it also encouraged the appreciation and acceptance of other beliefs and culture. You will learn how to accept what cultures are different than what you preach, and different types of values that you've never seen. So the more you're involved in different cultures, obviously the more you will be open-minded about it, and then you learn how to accept it. So lastly will be the productivity improvement, because the mindset is positive. So how does culture affect employee learning? It affects how we conduct work, our behavior and style, our use of language, how we solve challenges, problems, and conflicts, how we negotiate, and how we go about creating relationships. How should one start building good culture? Okay, so in order to build good culture, you have to learn how to utilize all parts of cultural intelligence, for example, your intercultural engagement. You have to be motivated, and your attitude has to be positive and outgoing. So yeah, you'll be able to engage in a good environment and work your best. So next one will be cultural understanding. You should know yourself and know the others as well. Learn how to accept how people are different than you, and accept people's opinion. So the intercultural communication will be the verbal, non-verbal communication styles. Next will be listen, be aware of your ears to others. Be empathic, speak to people's heart and mind. Lean in, be helpful. So you can be approachable, which will also improve good values and culture in an organization. So you can be respectful as well, because you will earn trust and you'll be trusted. It works vice versa. So you will have the ability to accept constructive criticisms and improve self from the mistakes made. Okay, so next will be the consequences of culture and values affecting the employee learning. Company will receive higher revenues, and also employee turnover rate will decrease, because if your employees enjoy, appreciate your workplace and the environment they're working in, and the values that they support, and they learn how to appreciate what you're working for, so obviously the turnover rate will be low. Okay, so you will improve the consistency of products and services as well, because if you enjoy what you're working, and then what you are doing for the job, you will be very consistent and persistent of the products you serve. So the last one will be encouraging employee job satisfaction. As I said earlier, so if you are satisfied with the job, you will do your best to achieve the good working performance. Okay, so now is the Q&A session. So anyone have questions? What are a few changes facing this organizational culture? So there are a few challenges that an organization can face. So one of the hardest ones will be to maintain the organizational culture. It depends on the employee, whether they
serve good working culture and values. So if they know how to, work on the strong and core values, they will reflect the company's culture the right way. So not every employee preach good values, which is why some companies they fail to maintain a good organizational culture because the employees are not able to share the good culture of the company. So not only that, maintaining a healthy organizational culture improves the employee engagement. So if a company is able to allow their employees to work in a very comfortable environment, so they are going to have to share good values and work on it, so the company will have very good performance. Okay, so second challenge should be to reinforce it at all times. So it is not easy to reinforce it the whole time because it has to be, good cultures and values has to be presented at all times, anytime, has to be constantly represented. So if an employee is not able to promote the culture in a good way all the time, then the company performance will decrease. So the values and ethics and the environment must be consistent as well. Okay, so next question.
What are the examples of strong and weak cultures?
Strong and weak cultures. Okay, the example of strong cultures will be positive thinking and widely shared values, obviously. So if a company is good, then the employee will be able to share the good culture of their company. And then for the weak culture will be narrow thinking, not being able to be open-minded about several things, and then too narrow-minded. And then the next one will be the employee unable to share the company's good culture. It is because, probably because of they are not satisfied with the working environment, or the job profit, and then they won't be able to share the good culture of the company. Okay, next question.
Why learn? What's the purpose of learning?
What's the purpose of learning? Learning is a discovery process. Everyone has to go through this process at a stage of their life. But learning every day is compulsory. No one stops learning. You learn until the day you die. So it leads to a better knowledge of the world around us and should help us to cope better with it. So you never stop learning. You learn and you change, constantly do it so you can improve yourself. Okay? Yeah, I think that's all. No more questions? No more? Okay, that's all from me. Thank you.